There was a time when barn owls were a common sight in Pennsylvania farm country, but a loss of habitat has caused a drastic drop in their numbers. The Milton Hershey School is working to change that, and News 8's Jack Hubley takes a look at nature's mousetrap in this morning's Wild Moment.
I'll bet you have a few of these lying around the house. It's a mousetrap, of course. Now let's take a look at the traditional version, the flying mousetrap, also known as the barn owl. Even at the age of 6.5 weeks, this little guy is already a rodent-eating machine. And thanks to the efforts of some folks at the Milton Hershey School, barn owls are on the increase in the Hershey area.
Barn owls need grassland habitat. That's because grasslands are home to the owl's favorite entree, the meadow vole, a small mouse-like rodent that makes up about 75% of the barn owl's diet. Grasslands have been disappearing in recent decades, and along with them, the barn owls. But that trend is reversing at the Milton Hershey School, where mowed areas are being converted to meadows made up of native grasses. The 1,500-acre Milton Hershey School campus already has 100 acres of native plant meadows, with another 200 acres of turf grass slated for conversion. And predictably, the barn owls are moving in. Anticipating demand for housing, the school erected 5 barn owl nest boxes in March of 2008. According to the school's environmental educator, Nate McKelvey, only 2 vacancies remain.
So far, we have 3 active barn owl sites, which is pretty unheard of in this area. In all of Pennsylvania, there's only about 75 active barn owl sites. So to have 3 in such a small area is really fantastic.
Recently, I was on hand to watch Nate and Pennsylvania Game Commission biologist Dan Mummert band 3 young owls living on a silo at the school's Bloomingdale farm. The school community turned out for the occasion. Hershey School 7th grader Amanda Dayton recorded data as Dan examined and banded the youngsters. With the exam over, Dan and Nate returned the young owls to their high-rise apartment.
It's just a perfect learning opportunity to make connections to the classroom and to people's everyday lives and to see just what we can do by simply managing our land in a way that can sustain grassland birds. To see them and to see them really thriving on campus is really inspiring.
I'm Jack Hubley, News 8.
And just how effective is the barn owl? Well, Jack says just 1 family of owls will eat 2,500 rodents a year. Can you believe that?
Good riddance to them. Not the most dapper looking birds, are they?
No, they seemed a little angry when they were being banded. I'm not going to lie.
They were not happy.